Hello, everybody. Welcome to another episode of Basin Electronics. Doing something a little different today. I don't think I've done very many of these, if any. I wanted to take apart one of these solar lights. Now, I bought a two-pack of these because I needed one for outside, but I didn't need both of them. And I thought the second one would be interesting to take apart because there's a lot of interesting information you get from these. Like, what kind of power cell do they use, and like what sort of charging chip do they have in order to convert like the solar power into the charging power for the battery? And solar power has always been a bit of an interest of mine, but I've never really had much of an opportunity to dive into it other than just buying the occasional solar deck light. Now, the light itself is nothing particularly spectacular. It has the solar cell on the top, has five of these triangular LED panels on it, and looks like just four standard screws to open it up. So let's now, I bought this light a few months ago, and as I mentioned, I have one of them mounted outside, and I've actually been really, really fond of it. It has three modes. One is just, one is a dusk to dawn mode, so if it gets dark, it turns on and stays on until it gets light again. Another one is it goes into a low light mode, and then if it detects motion, it goes bright. Then a third mode where it stays off unless it detects motion, then it turns on. And it's this third mode that I'm using. And the motion sensor on it, I think it's just a standard PIR. The motion sensor is really nice and sensitive and actually detects me the moment I get off the deck. So it's really, really useful. All right. So, as expected, this is pretty simple. Now, this doesn't surprise me. On the specs, it said it was a 3.7-volt circuit, which suggested it might have been an 18650 power cell. And it looks like I wasn't, an 18650. I was not disappointed. Manufactured January 2021, which is expected. Then we just have a simple controller board. I'm guessing it looks like maybe a power MOSFET, probably a power conversion chip to convert between the solar and the battery powered, and then probably a microcontroller to handle the inputs from the PIR and the button to change the modes. Right, so let's take this out. Of course, I have lots of gunk in here holding everything in, so I don't think that's going to come out very gracefully. This top one here, that's going up to the solar panel, and then these other pairs are going out to the LED panels. So there's just our momentary switch, our PIR, and was there a, nope, it just doesn't have a charge. I don't think it does. So it looks like all the circuitry's on this one end. have we got here? There's a negative. These are positive. It's all common positive. Solar negative. Solar positive, which goes into... Oh, that's a diode. Because it says D1 on the circuit board here. Let's see if I can make out that that chip. AY10W01. All right, I am going to look up that chip. I'm wondering if that's a power management chip or if that's just a general microcontroller. What we got here? We have, so one side of the switch, that's interesting, they only soldered one end and left the other ends of the switch unsoldered. I guess you don't really need both ends soldered, but a little lazy. So anyways, that goes around to pin on the, so I'm thinking this is just a microcontroller, and then this being the PIR, yeah, so one of the legs of the PIR goes into a different leg of the microchip. It goes into a capacitor. That's probably a smoothing. And then this is the negative rail here. All right, so let's look up that chip and see if we can find anything out about it. All right, I've done some research on the chip, and there isn't a lot of information. I wasn't able to find a data sheet. Some of that might just be my own inexperience, but I wasn't able to find a specific data sheet. But what I have been able to determined about this chip is it's built by a Chinese company called Ameway, A-M-E-W-A-Y, and it looks like it's purpose-built for these kind of lights. A couple of sites I found, like I found one where this is a Chinese site, but looks like he actually took it apart, kind of experimented with this particular light, and then gave a link to this particular distributor of these kind of solar lights. This obviously isn't the same manufacturer that made my lights, but it is almost, it's pretty much the exact same setup though. So it looks like this chip is a kind of a dedicated chip for this kind of patio light. It has the so it has like the solar charging built into it. It has the activation pins from the PIR, as well as the different modes programmed into it from the push button. One site that I looked at said that it was a microcontroller, so maybe there's some programmability to it, so this button actually has different features depending on the model. Like there might be a model that only does like off or motion detection. But again, I wasn't able to find a data sheet, so I couldn't really tell you. But looking at the simplicity of the circuitry, it definitely supports the idea that this is a dedicated chip. So, I'm going to finish this video here. I really hope you found this interesting, if not informative. I certainly found it both. I've always wanted to take one of these apart and kind of see what was inside. I think the 18650 battery cell was an interesting find. Again, I kind of expected it, but it was interesting to see my suspicions confirmed on that. But thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Goodbye.